everybody. Welcome to FTB Infinity. So last time on FTB Infinity, we were able to craft this, a safari net, bleep, which is reusable. Bleep. You don't even know what happened to you. That is very, very nice because it's going to allow us to set up a spawn system for things that we need. And the big thing that we need right now is ender pearls. And I think actually ender pearls and blaze rods are two big things that we need. And so we need blazes and endermen. And what we're going to do is set up a spawning system for them. Because that's actually the next step that we need to do. Now, I've given some thought to the spawn system and stuff. And, you know, when I designed the Kawasa base here, I actually designed it with, you know, this as a level, this as a level, and then down here, this as a level too. So I designed it with these kind of three tiers in mind. I don't know how much I want to use this down here. I just don't know. I mean, I don't know how much equipment and stuff I would want to put down there or anything. But what I can tell you is I've been thinking about this level here. Now, I've got some farmland going on, and obviously I've got, like, you know, my nether wart thing going on here. And I have one blaze rod, so I could make a brewing stand and start brewing stuff. But I think what I want to do is use this also for this is kind of the farm, so it's going to be mob farm. Now don't come down here. Everybody came down here. I know he just came down here from up there. Get back. You know what? We're gonna Pokemon, wanna catch them? Oh, now I'm just, yep, there goes copyright. I'll get a copyright strike. There we go. You're coming back up here, buddy. Fella. Old chum. Stay. He'll probably come down in just a second. So anyway, I want to set up the spawn system here, and really what I want to do is set up not just a spawn system for, mobs to kill, but also for animals to kill too. So I'm going to kind of I'm thinking about if there's a way I can combine the two, and I don't know that there is. But let's see what we can do here. Now I've got the old staircase back down into the strip mine and into the abandoned mine shaft down there. I can always redo that if need be. I can also, I've also got like half of the way drilled through to, you know, to here. But the only issue is that I think right underneath here is the beginning of a, what do you call those things? Ravine. I think the ravine kind of moseys off that away or something like that. I'm not sure, but I think it kind of does. So I'm going to have to be careful about that. I don't want to really get into the ravine. I mean, I guess it doesn't matter at the end of the day, but, you know, whatever. Anyway, so let's talk about how this would work. You know what, I'm going to build this. And I will come back and we'll take a look at what we've got and see what's going on. Okay. Now. Okay, welcome back. And the spawners area is done. So this is going to enclose a quad spawner, and let's just go in. Let me see here. I can use this wrench to show you what's going on inside of the wall here. So this is Ender IO, of course, and you've got your power. The green thing there is the fluid for the tank essence, and then I've got the red up here, the redstone. Thing for the actual lights and stuff. And then inside Dang, I just lost that forever. Nope. Okay, the quad spawner is done. I have set it up, I've wired it up, and I've done a little bit of testing to make sure that it works right, and it does. So let's take a tour of it. So the first thing is the inside here, which is got Ender IO. These are painted blocks. So power, the mob essence comes out of the grinder and goes into this tank, and then it also gets pushed into the rest of the piping. And then up there you see that redstone conduit, so it turns the lights on, and this is what the inside looks like. So the inside, you can see that I've got the spot ready for the auto spawner when we're ready for it. I set the Skelly spawner that we had in our Diamond Dolly in place. And let's go ahead and turn it off, and then let's see what it's looking like. Put that there, and I will put you there. So you turn it off, and it shuts those lights off. Those lights are power lights from Ender IO also. And look at that. Boom. Just like nobody's business. And it's filling up the essence tank and dropping these on the floor. Oop, you died, sir. And let's see here. What? So you... So everything just gets funneled right to this mob grinder. And everything should be cool. So the next things that we need to do, or the next thing that we need to do, is get more spawners, and I think I'm going to do, so I can have a Skelly, two others, natural spawners, and then the auto spawner, and the natural spawners will feed the mob essence to the auto spawner, so that should work out just fine when we're ready to build that auto spawner. The only problem with the auto spawner is this. That's the mob grinder. I want the spawner. So let's just do that. Spawner. Here's the auto spawner. Mine factory reloaded. And look what let me hit escape. Look what I need. I need emeralds. Now, I purposefully put Gurr in those... in the mine area that we were in. I did that on purpose because it said that it was Extreme Hills, and you know, in Extreme Hills you should have the emeralds, just the natural ore, and he has yet to find one, and he's done two of those excavations, and he's not found any, so I'm a little concerned that maybe the generation for, you know, feed the beast isn't working right like it's supposed to, or, you know, it's a biomes of plenty thing, or I don't know what the deal could be. But in any event, it's not working right. But one thing that we can go do is get the witch spawner and the blaze spawner, and at least get blaze rods and stuff like that. And then we'll talk about kind of my plans for going and getting emeralds, because I will definitely... I will fall down first. Oh, look at you. Wandering around down here. I'm definitely going to need an auto spawner to do the Ender Pearls for sure. So I've got a full jetpack. Let's put that on. And I've got my Diamond Dolly. And it looks like it's daytime. And you're in my way, sir. So let's go take a walk out here and see exactly what time it is. If it's too late, I'll go take a snooze. Oh, it's just morning. Perfect. So I won't even cut this at all, because I know where there's a witch spawner at. And that witch spawner is just right over here. So here's a cool little village. Fish for emerald. Fish for emeralds. Fella, you are coming with me. Yep. Okay, and to get rid of those particle effects, we're gonna, or those effects, we're gonna put you in there, and away we go. Okay, so let's test this out and see what we get here. Aha! Sticks and sugar and... Oh, what's that? Is that a bow? Ooh! Wow! I have yet to get a bow out of these guys, but yeah, that's good. Well, that's great. There's some spoiler eyes and some more bow. Okay, let's turn the lights back on. Because I'm definitely not ready for... I'm definitely not ready for this. We need to set up some storage for all this stuff. And for now, I'm going to put it over here, although it's going to eventually go straight up the line there. So, okay, we're back in the Nether, and I'm done with my processing. And the reason why I did that was because I'm going to be in the Nether, so I wanted to make sure I had some potions. And I have also taken away most of my good stuff here. I'm going to use my Ender Sword. Hopefully I'll get some... I've got some decent stuff. You know, of course I've got my good... But I'm using really crappy stuff because if I lose it, I don't care. Although I will kind of care if I lose my jetpack. So I will have to keep an eye on my armor and everything else. Now, so I'm looking for a blaze spawner. Oh, great. The particles are going to be in my way. I'm looking for a blaze spawner. I know that there's a fortress right over there because I went over there, and that spawn is right there, and then the fortress is kind of right there. So according to Minecraft law, there should be a fortress actually over this way. So we're going to go, oh, and there's a, oh, that's not a bat. That's just a wisp. I don't too much care about wisps, but so let's go over here, and I'm going to actually get down low because I generally have better luck going down low, and hopefully we're not going to encounter too much lag. If I do, I may have to go find a safe spot and restart the game because I'm really, I've been having trouble with some lag in the Nether. Aha. Nope, no time for you, dude. Yeah, I've got a lot of lag going on here. So it shouldn't be too far away. And I'm not leaving torches or okay, can I go up this way? I'm not leaving torches or beacons because I've pretty much got my waypoints. And let's see here. So I'm just traveling in this general, I don't know whether this is west or east or what, and I might, yeah, that looks like it's a way through here. Looking for a fortress. Bingo! Bingo, bango, bongo. Okay, so let's see here if this fortress has been plundered. Is it an underground fortress? Might be most... Oh, wait. Nope. Place spawner that's covered up. Okay, so somebody wanting to use this. And is there another blaze spawner? Withered. I don't have any. Oh, I'm so lagging. Okay, ooh. Wow. What happened there? I got hit something fierce. And then withered on top of that. Oh, there's another blaze spawner. Okay, if that one's covered, I'm going to... No! And I have some severe lag here. I'm going to have to restart my client in any event. So I'm not rage quitting. We're going to go back and get my stuff. And it's not that far away, but that's some severe lag. So, yeah, let me do that, and I'll be right back with you. Okay, we're back again. I made it back to the base. I'm decked out in my backup gear. And we're off. I hope that this works out okay, and I forgot my fire resist potion. I left it. It was in my, my inventory when I died. So, hopefully I can get there before I run out of jet fuel. This doesn't have a ton of jet fuel. But we're gonna try and find out... Yeah, this could be bad pretty quick. I could be in some serious trouble. I'm already down 5% of my fuel just getting down here. So, this could be a little sticky wicket. And I'm going to use it. Well, I'm only 500 blocks away. So, I hopefully am not going to be too bad off. I hope. I'm down 10% of my fuel, but I'm a fifth of the way there. Yeah, this is going to be tight for sure no matter what. Oh, nope. Stay away from me. I do not want to fight you. Holy moly, what's the deal here? Oh my gosh, I'm gonna die again! Die again! Crap. Alright, back again. I have created... How do I do it? There we go. The armored reinforced jetpack. Let's get you going and taken care of here. Okay, we're going to start over again in the Nether. I brewed up some potions of healing and some potions of speed, and I'm hoping... So I'm going to have that on my bar there. I'm going to drink this now. And I'm going to hope that this gives me some speed just right off the bat. So we can do that, and let's just see here. I think it might, even in jetpack mode, I think I can use it for speed. So let's go find out. No, maybe not. Okay, so we may still have a problem with the bees. If that's just the case, then so be it. We'll just have to deal with it. And let's get to the first death point, or the last death point, because that was the first one. I'm going to put a wide berth around these bees here, and hopefully they will not come after me. As I do not want to engage them. Then I came up here, right? Yep. You stay away. I want nothing from you. And then do I have a... crap. Or maybe it was down below. I think it might have been down below. I thought it was up here. Maybe it was down here. No, there is no down here. See, I came over here, and then I thought I came up here. Maybe not. Maybe I lost it. Maybe death was not saved for me. That would be... that will suck. So death is 1 meter. Yeah. I do not see a... ah! Nope, I was. Okay, so... okay. So it was saved for me here. Let's go ahead and get you out. Thank you. Was anything... okay, so let's just go ahead and swap, because this is slightly better protection for me. Good. And moving on to the next death point. And actually, I think this sword is better than this sword, so we'll swap you out. There's some more bees that I do not want to deal with, but I may have to now. Next death point with some... okay. So I actually even thought about covering this up, because I knew... and that's where, I think that's where, because I know that they didn't come from here, the wither skeleton. Ah! Jerkos! You're just coming from everywhere. Okay. And this is slightly better, I think, than that. I'm okay with everything else. Let's put my... thing there. I've got you. I'm going to put my power two bow down here. And I'll put my pick there. Oh, no. I'll put my pick there. And I don't know why I'd want torches on the bar, but there we go. And let's drink this, which is my fire resist potion. Because I'll probably get shot at when I go to get this spawner right here. And yes, that's the spawner I want. And we're just going to go yoink now. I did not bring my golden bag of holding. Does not matter, though, it looks like. It looks like that only matters for walking around purposes. So let's get back to the base. Okay, so let's do this. And that spawner's gonna go over here. And let us place you thusly. Perfecto. And get rid of you. And I don't care if I lose you or not. Okay. And let's go ahead and start. Let's check this out and see what happens. Holy moly. Oh, wow. There we go. There's plenty of junk coming out of there. My inventory is super mega full now. There's some blaze rods that I want to make sure I get. Well, I guess it doesn't matter. And look at all of this stuff. Where does all this stuff come from? This is... Oh, I got a saddle. Oh, I know what. It's from the 1.7 fishing mechanic where you get all that junk now. Well, let's get our... Let me get my inventory cleaned up here because it's a mess already. And yeah, we'll come back and do some cool stuff. So some of you might be saying, you know, Carl, why aren't you moving some of your stuff over here? Why are you having to run back and forth? And my point is that most of my crafting I want to do in there. I have to do it over here for now because I've got all this stuff over here. I suppose I could move this over to there. My point is that as soon as I get this auto spotter done and I load up a... Enderman guy thing, I will be set. And then we will start making all kinds of ender ducts and run them throughout the base. So that is the whole point of all this. In case you were wondering, oh, I've got one of those. What am I doing here? What am I needing to do here? One of them. And then this will become primarily crafting area and storage, which... I guess true crafting area and true storage. So let's go ahead and finish this up. I'm going to move. I think that these guys are spawning in places that... I think that the... I keep on hearing the zombies spawning outside the wall here. And I think they're spawning in places just far enough away. And then they're getting attracted. I don't know how they're getting up here, though. So I want to... I may just take a day and just, like, a night and just watch and see where they're spawning or at least where they're coming from. Okay, let's get the plastic sheets going, and let's make a spawner. Ba-bum! There's an Ender Bob. Okay, let's get you off. Let's get you off by ourselves. Gotcha. Okay. Spawner down. Okay. this has been a rousing success. Less than 5 minutes of operation here. Full operation. I'm barely using any essence because I've got so many other, you know, three other spawners supplying essence to this tank. And in less than 5 minutes, two full stacks of Ender Pearls. All of this. I gotta figure out what that's... Oh, that's RF tools. So, I think I'm gonna... If anything, my danger now is I'm gonna run out of room. Yeah. So, okay, I'm gonna end the episode here. Thanks for joining me. And, yeah, we are going to be rocking and rolling in stuff. The next... thing that I got to figure out is how to turn the auto spawner on and off with this switch here, but that will happen. I'm not worried about that at all on any level. So yeah, thanks for joining me. Oh, wow, there's pufferfish. There's another bow. Oh, no. Wow, a power four bow. Crazy. Yeah, I'm going to run out of room for all the stuff that I need to do. But I'm ready to start really setting things up now. We went from not having anything and not being anywhere to within two episodes or three episodes. Kaboom, we are rocking serious loot. So look at that, almost three stacks. Just talking right now. Look at all the sticks. We're going to have more sticks than we know what to do with. Yeah, so... And blaze rods, aplenty. Oh, still only 46 blaze rods. So, with plenty of sulfur. I was worried about sulfur too, but plenty of sulfur. So, okay. Thanks for joining me. I'm going to get away from here. Thanks for joining me. If you like this, give me a thumbs up, please. It really helps me out and keeps me motivated and stuff. So, otherwise, I will see you later. Ta-ta! Ta-ta! Ta-ta!